all around us. I want the praise team to come and sing.
Amen.
At least one or two. All right. And then we have some other things that we need to do.
Praise the Lord. We ask that you would stand with us this morning as we worship the Lord.
Yes.
As soon as we get the machine hooked up.
My life is in you, Lord.
you for the songs today. Glory to God. Wednesday night, we had a wonderful service.
Man.
And one of the young ladies rededicated her life to God.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
And I want her to come this morning. I want to ask her something. Listen, come forward this morning. Praise God. How you feel this morning? Feel fine? Praise God. Did you rededicate your life to the Lord Wednesday night?
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
You feel like God hears your prayers, takes care of everything?
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
I want to pray over you this morning, but I'd like for Philip to come this morning.
Amen.
Come on, Philip.
Thank you, my Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you, my Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise my Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
Praise God. Philip, appreciate you. God bless you. I think that before we pray, we have something that we need to do. You want to do? I want you to read this card out loud, okay? Turn around. I want you to read it out loud.
Have life, we pray, have breath in their bodies.
We thank you today, Lord, because we know that you still hear our cries. And Lord, anyone else that's here this morning that has requests, maybe other requests, Lord, different ways, different things. God, may they realize this morning that God is still on the throne. God still answers your prayer. We thank you. We give you praise, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for all your prayers.
Yes, amen.
Glory to God. The ones that missed our revival, that was unable to make it to the revival, I want to encourage you to try your best to plan to come to this revival, because you just don't know what you missed.
That's right.
You missed a blessing.
Yes.
So be sure and come to the revival if you can.
Yes.
I have another situation I got to deal with this morning. Don't have to, but I'm going to. And that's Doug.
Amen.
Doug is going to become a member of our church today. Brother Doug, come on and stand here.
Thank you,
Jesus. Praise God. God's got his hand upon Doug.
Yes, he does.
And his precious wife.
Amen.
Yes.
And we are needing in our church a youth leader.
Yes.
And I'm praying that God will work it out for us. And who knows, Doug may be our youth leader in our church.
Yes.
And other things that God has in store. And thank the Lord for all the young people that are here.
Yes. Amen.
Praise God. Doug, I want to impress upon you this morning as a young man that God requires for you to be faithful to his house, to the house of God, especially when you become a part of the family of God. You become an arm, heart, you know, and it takes every part for the family of God to function as it needs to. I want to ask you a question, and I want you to answer me this morning. Wait till I get through, okay? Doug, will you be faithful to the church? Will you support the church? Our fundamental beliefs, what we believe, you know, and do whatever you can and support the church with your tithes and offerings. You'll do it with all of this, okay? That's what we have to ask all of our people to do. And because we're not doing it for ourselves, we're doing it for our family. You are the family, and we're doing it for God. Praise God. So, Doug, turn around, and I want everyone, we want to make this as quick as possible this morning, but we want to come by and shake Doug's hand and hug his neck. Tell him that you love him, okay?
Amen.
These two young ladies right here to front start this.
Amen.
Brother Murray, come on. This side and then this side.
Thank you.
Doug didn't know that he had so many people to pray for. Praise God. Appreciate you, Doug. Pray that God's blessings will be upon you. Praise God. I have one thing that I want to read to you this morning, and I know that the church has a copy of this, but it's not exactly like the one I have. And I wanted to read you this one. And I remember I went through some of these steps myself, probably most of us here. The name of his father says, 4 years of age, my daddy can do anything. This is as we get older. 7 years, my dad knows lots and a whole lot more. 11 years, my dad doesn't quite know everything. 13 years, oh well, naturally, dad doesn't know everything. At 16 years of age, dad, hopelessly, old-fashioned. 19 years of age, oh, that man is out of date. What did you expect? Remember those times?
Oh, yeah.
25 years, he knows a little bit about it, but not much. 30 years, when we get 30 years of age, let's find out what Dad thinks about it. 35 years of age, a little patient, let's get Dad's meaning first. 50 years of age, all of you that are 50 years of age and older know what I'm talking about. What would Dad have thought about it? 60 years of age, my dad knew barely everything. Then at 65 years of age, I wish I could talk it over with my dad once more. How true that is. You know, as a young person, we think Dad don't know anything. He's just an old bogey. You know, all he's good for is mowing the yard and working on the car and working on a job and mowing down two jobs if necessary, you know, and whatever it is. Well, anyway, thank you. And appreciate today. Today is Father's Day, and all you dads are here. We pray that you have a good day today.
All right? Yeah.
Praise God. There's no one in a hurry, I'm sure, this morning.
That's right.
All right, because if you get in a hurry and you go to the restaurant, they're going to be crowded out.
Uh-huh.
And you're going to stand in line and wait.
Yeah.
So why don't we just go ahead and enjoy what God has for us this morning?
Yeah.
Praise God. Glory to God. I asked the priest team to sing one more chorus for us this morning, ladies, and one more.
In your presence.
may be seated this morning.